I just said most of this, but I'm a dabbler in roguelikes. I have many unfinished prototype projects, as I'm sure some of you might be able to relate. My day job is at Monomi Park. I work on Slime Rancher as a game engineer. And my social and itch things are there if you want to check any of this out or give me a follow. So that's the who. These are the what, how, when, where, why that I'm going to be talking about. So what do I mean by rituals, and what do we do with them? How can we generate them, and how can we use them within a game, specifically a roguelike context? And when, where, why, I kind of have grouped together because it's, you know, when do we want to use this? Where within the structure of our game does it make sense? And why is it interesting from a developer and from a player perspective? So first, what, just a kind of working definition for rituals for the context of this talk. A ritual is a repeatable set of actions that cause some effect within the game world indirectly. And the indirectly is kind of the important thing here, because you might say, aha, if I hit a goblin with my sword 5 times, it dies. Is that the ritual of goblin slaying? No, I mean, for you it can be, sure. But for the purposes of this talk, let's say no. Really what we're looking at is you do the series of actions, and some external force or system is what will drive the effect that you want to happen to actually occur. So this is something I looked into last year during Proc Jam. I made a system for generating some rituals just to create endless spell books. So they have little ProcGen icons and ProcGen text, and I'll read one of these because the font is a bit flowery. So I have a charm to bring fortune to your ally, and it says to shatter a pearl upon the earth, and then shout the name of your ally, and look towards the west, and chant the holy verse, and burn a stick of time, and draw the bet rune in the air to complete the ritual. And the idea is that you would be able to do this within a game, and it would bring fortune to your ally for whatever that might mean. So maybe it applies a bless buff or something like that. And then I have one to bless a hammer, which is a similar kind of almost hokey pokey-esque system for doing a particular set of steps to bring about a certain effect. Some inspirations for this, of course, there's, you know, for as long as humans have existed, there have been real life practices of various rituals, whether it be magic or the, you know, real life study of alchemy or throughout various religions. But also within roguelikes, you know, there's a Elbereth, there's an Elbereth out there in front of the statue. This is a real ritual that works within NetHack that you can write, you know, a magic word upon the ground and protect yourself from harm. And then in sort of more of a meta sense, if you look at speed running or glitch techniques within games, you might see, you know, players who have discovered, oh, if I open up this menu and then move in a certain way and then select this and drop that, I can pass through a wall. And those are rituals that sort of exist between the real world and the game world. They're not intentional, usually, but they have the same kind of power in that you're taking a set of actions and then using it to create a magical effect within a world. So in game terms, I'm looking at a system for, you know, building these rituals procedurally and interpreting them so that they can actually be used within a game. An important thing that I wanted to have here is that it's not just accessed through a menu, so you're not going into your rituals menu and hitting, you know, do bless ritual, because at that point it's no different than any other spell system within a game. And really, I wanted to cut out all of the UI interactions that you would have to directly select this, so you wouldn't, you know, even if you're casting a bless ritual, you wouldn't then get, you know, a UI pop-up to say, like, okay, who do you want to cast it on? It's important, I think, that that information is contained within the ritual itself. And that's one of the challenges, is when you're generating a set of steps to do these things, you need to be aware of, you know, what are the requirements that this effect has that I need to satisfy through doing the ritual. So if the spell needs a target, something that I'm doing in this ritual has to say who the target is. If I'm blessing you, you know, against certain elements, or if I'm, you know, enchanting my weapon with a particular type of energy, I need to specify that within the ritual itself. So how do we do that? We make a generator. And so the generator that I came up with takes a, you know, big list of all of the verbs and nouns that it's interested in. And this list might, you know, within a game already exist in some form. If you're using some kind of action pattern, you might already have all of your verbs enumerated in some way, along with the nouns that they can be associated with. And basically, we're going to use these to generate our set of steps. The effects that we're interested in, you know, they might require a target, or they might require an element, or they might require a magnitude, which is like how powerful is the effect that I'm doing. And so first what I want to do is create associations between certain types of nouns or verbs and these elements or magnitude or what have you. So some of this might be pre-authored. I might say, hey, when I go to generate this, the fire rune is always going to be associated with fire, because if it's associated with water, nobody's going to understand why that is. Some of it might be something that we come up with on the fly, though. So if you have a whole alphabet of runes, you could say, okay, the foo rune is associated with water, and the thark rune is associated with air. And that's a system that can change between each run of your game, or however often you're generating these. And the cool thing about that is that players will learn this over time. And so you can create parallel rituals. So, you know, if they find a scrap of paper containing the fire bless ritual that says use the foo rune, and they know that the thark rune is associated with water, they might be able to put together, hey, if I swap out this rune for that rune, I can get a different effect. So part of what we need to do is basically create these associations and then pick steps to satisfy the effects for the generator. This is some of my data. It's kind of hard to read. I work in Unity. But so I have, you know, the different verbs and nouns, and they're just tagged with strings to determine what can associate with what. And then I have a whole listing of everything. This is a very small list. Obviously, for any kind of big generator like this, the larger your combination possibility between your verbs and your nouns, the more interesting and diverse rituals you can come up with. So we start with, you know, we have an effect that we want to do, like cause protection from some element, and that's going to require what element and who we're protecting. So we might say, hey, our verb is to draw, and we want to draw the fire rune, and that's, you know, establishing the element that we are going to protect from fire, because we've created that association ahead of time. And then we want to say, hey, you're going to speak the target's name, and that's going to establish the target. So, you know, within the context of actually running this within a game world, you would have some kind of lookup for, you know, determining which actual actor game object is associated with each name, and you might already have this, or, you know, have some way to do it. But this speak target's name could just as easily be, you know, burn a scrap of their hair or something, if you have systems for grabbing those and creating those associations between different actions the player can take and entities within your game world. And then, of course, because this is a boring ritual on its own, we pad it out with some structure to give it kind of more of a ritualistic flavor rather than just doing two things and then an effect happens. So, you know, in this case, the ritual that we've created is you step north and then draw the fire rune and then step south and speak the target's name and then draw a circle and then you step to the west and then, magically, you've protected your target from fire. So how do we go from that to actually interpreting this within the game world? The interpreter system that I built for this is actually really simple. It's just taking the list of things in the previous slide, and you know, every action that you do within the game, you report up to this interpreter saying, hey, the player stepped north, hey, the player did this or that. And we just track progress along each of these lists. I add a bit of fudging for, you know, allowing things in between, because you may have to do a few intervening actions in order to draw something. If you need to, like, take out chalk or something, it wouldn't make sense for that to disrupt the ritual. But also not allowing it to go forever so that you can kind of distinguish between when a player is intentionally doing this or if they happen to accidentally hit all of the milestones throughout their 10-hour run and then, you know, suddenly a spell pops off and they have no idea why. And then, you know, from there, we just notify whatever system you already have for doing spells to actually do the thing. So presumably you've been passing up this information to your interpreter. It says, hey, the player has achieved doing this ritual. We know the information because we've been gathering it through the stuff that they've done. Now, you know, call your action thing to do whatever spell happens and let the player know that it happened. So that's the what and the how. I think the more interesting is when, where, why. Probably not combat, because if you have to do a dance to cast a fireball, you're probably not going to live very long in most games. But maybe, like, you know, depending on your game, maybe that's viable. I think longer-term effects, this makes sense. So, you know, enchanting equipment, applying buffs, healing, doing things that you might do these rituals before you go into a dangerous room. If you know that there's a boss on the other side of a door and you have a ritual that will protect you, maybe that's worth doing. A cool thing about this is you can provide magic effects to characters who wouldn't otherwise have them. So, you know, maybe you can allow a fighter class to do these rituals. They don't normally have access to, you know, enchanting or whatever, but because they found a book that had these spells in it, they can do some of it. And that brings me to the coolest point, I think, is that you can embed a textual representation of these rituals within in-game books or dialogue, or, you know, players can find these things throughout the world and then use that knowledge. It's tricking people into reading your in-game text because you're providing value there. And I think that's really neat. So that's my talk. Thank you all for listening. Please give me a follow. We have time for one question. Does anyone want to?
Oh no, there are two questions. Maybe we have time for. Okay.
Have you thought about, like, what happens when someone flubs a ritual, or, you know, like, is there a failure, or does weird shit happen?
Yeah, so, you know, if you flub a ritual, I think it's definitely something that you could pretty easily track. You know, if we want to say, because we don't want it to be the case that, oh, the first step of doing ritual A is that you step to the north. We don't want to consider it a failure if the player steps to the north and then goes north again, because they're just walking north. But maybe we can reach a point where, say, you're 90% through a ritual or some percentage that makes sense, where we can say with certainty that the player is trying to do this thing. And then, sure, yeah, you know, maybe they flub a ritual and instead of protecting someone from fire, they set them on fire. And maybe that's even something we can do intentionally, is like now they know, hey, if I tweak this ritual, now I can set people on fire. So yeah, that would be awesome. Thank you.
Thank you so much.